We want to match the graphs to the correct equations. We should be able to recognize that the first function, y equals 10 to the power of x, and y equals e to the power of x, are both exponential functions. And since the bases are greater than 1, these both represent exponential growth. But for y equals 10 to the power of x, the base is 10. And for y equals e to the power of x, the base is e, which is approximately equal to 2.718. And since the base of y equals 10 to the power of x is greater than the base of y equals e to the power of x, the exponential growth rate is going to be greater for y equals 10 to the power of x, which means the graph of this function is going to be increasing faster than the graph of this function. The blue and red graphs represent exponential growth, but notice how the red function is increasing faster because it's going uphill faster from left to right. And therefore, the red graph will be the graph of y equals 10 to the power of x. And the blue graph will be the graph of y equals e to the power of x. Of course, if we needed to, we could also find points on each function and match it to the graph. So for example, for y equals 10 to the power of x, if x was equal to 1, notice how the y coordinate would be 10 to the first, or 10. And for y equals e to the x, if x is equal to 1, y would be equal to e, or approximately 2.718. So notice that the point 1 comma 10 would be off the screen, but it does look like the red graph would pass through that point, because notice when x is equal to 1 on the blue function, the y value is less than 3, which would be approximately 2.718, or e. So we do have the exponential functions identified correctly. Now let's take a look at the log functions. We have y equals natural log x, and we have y equals log x. Remember, natural log x is log base e, and for y equals log x, this is common log. Since there's no base listed, we assume it's base 10. And if we wrote these log functions as exponential functions, remember this means e to the power of y is equal to x, and this means 10 to the power of y is equal to x. So again, e to the power of y is equal to x, and 10 to the power of y is equal to x. These are equivalent equations, or they mean the same thing. Written this way, we should recognize that y equals 10 to the power of x and x equals 10 to the power of y would be inverse functions. Notice how the x and y variables have been interchanged. And x equals e to the y and y equals e to the x are also inverse functions, which means if y equals e to the x contains the point 1 comma e, then y equals natural log x would have to contain the point x coordinate of e and a y coordinate of 1. Notice how the coordinates have been interchanged. And if y equals 10 to the x contains the point 1, 10, then y equals log x must contain the point 10, 1. Notice how the coordinates of this point here satisfy the equation x equals 10 to the y. If y is 1, x is 10. And the point e comma 1 satisfies the equation x equals e to the y. Notice if y is equal to 1, the right side would be e, and x would also be e. So going back over to our graphs, again, notice how the point 10, 1 would be off the screen, but the only function that would pass through that point would be the green function. And for the point e 1, remember e is approximately 2.7, that would be the point right about here, where again, the x coordinate is e and the y coordinate is 1. Therefore, y equals natural log x would be the black function. So this one's a little bit challenging because there aren't a lot of key points shown on this graph based upon the scale of the coordinate plane. But again, if we can recognize which log functions and exponential functions are inverses, it is helpful to match graphs with equations. And when dealing with inverses, there is one more thing that we could do to help. We could graph the line y equals x, which is a line with a y-intercept of 0 and a slope of 1, would look something like this. Inverse functions are symmetrical across this line, so with this line sketched, we can tell that the blue function and the black function are symmetrical across the line y equals x, as well as the green function and the red function. Again, notice how the blue and black functions are the functions y equals e to the x and y equals natural log x, and the red and green functions are the functions y equals 10 to the x and y equals log x, or y equals log base 10 of x. Okay, I hope this explanation helps.